I don't gotta dance, I'm at money move. I don't gotta dance. Alright, got that. Good? We're good. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another Monday Motivator. My name's Derek, and before we get started, welcome to... First of all, if you're new to the channel, welcome to the Darby Life. Make sure you hit that subscribe button down in the bottom corner, one of those corners, whatever it is. Hit that bell so you're notified when we make a video. You can follow us on the Darby Life on Instagram as well. All right, this is round two of the Monday Motivator. If you missed last week's, make sure you check that out at the end of the video. Today we're going to talk about get to versus have to. I wanted to do these Monday Motivators to help redefine your mental approach to life. Like I said in the previous videos, if I can help one person change their view, if I can make one person have a better day, then I've accomplished my goal. Don't forget to share this video with your friends, your coworkers, strangers, I don't care. Share it, because it may help somebody. Today we're going to talk about get to versus have to. How much of your day is spent doing things you have to do as opposed to things you get to do? Think about that. How much of your day is spent having to do things you have to do versus things that you get to do? Today, my goal is to help redefine your perception, because as they say, perception is reality. So if you can perceive things differently, then hopefully your view and your perception on life will change. The majority of successful people in this world live in the get-to zone. They spend most of their day getting to do something rather than having to do something. My wife's calling me again. Hello, baby. I seem to always be doing this as you're coming home from work. Do you want to say hi to the people that are watching the Monday Motivator video?
Hi.
The purple bag, I think. Beef and bean burritos. Okay, bye. Simple modifications in your mental approach can make a massive difference in your quality of life. All right, so let's talk about some examples of have to versus get to. And these are three examples that will impact, or a lot of people will be able to relate to in some form or fashion, right? So work. I have to go to work versus I get to go to work. A lot of people in this country, not only this country, but other countries around the world, are unemployed. They don't have a job. They can't find jobs for, you know, this reason or that. You are part of a population of people that say, I get to go to work. I get to go flip burgers. I get to go talk to people on a phone. I get to manage a group of people where I work. I get to go to meetings. I get to go to hiring events. Whatever it may be, I get to do that versus I have to do that. What about go to school? The majority of kids in third world countries don't even have paper or a pencil to write on or to write with, let alone afford or get the privilege to go to school or get some sort of education. 32 million American adults are functionally illiterate. Think about that. 32 million American adults are functionally illiterate. So to be able to say that you get to go to school, that's huge. There are tons, obviously millions of people in America that wish they could afford to go to college. People that drop out of high school because of this or that. You know, there are tons of people that would love to be in your position that say that you get to go to school. I get to change diapers versus I have to change diapers. That one's a big one for me sometimes. I'm lucky enough that Christina is a fantastic mom. She really helps out a lot around the house. And more times than not, she's the one who is changing the diapers. But whenever it's my turn to change the diapers, I get to change the diaper versus I have to change the diaper. I feel extremely fortunate that I'm able to be a father, that I was even given that opportunity. There are a ton of families beyond this lens, beyond the screen, maybe some of you even watching, who don't get that opportunity. So I'm extremely grateful. And if you do have that opportunity, you should be extremely grateful as well, because there are a lot of people that would rather be in your situation and get to change diapers versus have to. So with that being said, let's redefine our have to's. Let's change our mental approach. Not only to Mondays, this is the Monday motivator, but this obviously plays in every day of your life. What do you get to do versus have to do? And when you can flip that, when you can flip that thinking, I get to do this versus I have to do that, you will be successful. Life is a mental game. The more mentally strong we are, the more prepared we are for obstacles that we come across. I'm gonna leave you to this. The quality of your language determines the quality of your life. Think about that. The quality of your language determines the quality of your life. The more positive you are, the positive words you spread, the better life you'll live, right? Perception is reality. Change your perception, live a better life. With that being said, dominate your day every day. Don't forget to hit that subscribe in the bottom corner, smash that like, comment down below. We'll see you next time. See ya!